There's a universe, there's a definition that's already been established as to what a musician is. Your understanding of a musician doesn't negate what a musician is. You are, I get that. I'm not talking about what you could be or what you could be additionally. You either are a musician or you're not. Okay, but that wasn't the question that I asked you. You can explain that if you choose, but you are not answering the question. Are you a musician, yes or no? I've been listening to hundreds of YouTube videos and just gaining information because I can't afford to sit on the couch with a shrink at $350 or $400 an hour. You know, so I've had to really go in and do the work myself, and it has literally been equivalent to doing open heart surgery while I'm awake with no anesthesia. That's how difficult this has been. I have 100% concluded that the primary reason the world is in disarray, families and nations and states are in disarray, is because we don't take the time to listen to each other. We allow our feelings, our thoughts, our beliefs, and our emotions to interfere. And it's okay to have emotions and feelings because it's, you know, it's how, where we get instinct from. It's how we know how to protect ourselves, and you know, it's a natural reaction. But we have a mind and a consciousness for a reason, and we're not supposed to allow those emotions to overpower our consciousness. And because we have strong feelings about something, we respond to how we feel as opposed to how what we hear. And I am convinced that if we're patient enough with each other and we take the time to listen to each other and or listen to or investigate what's actually at hand in life, and then we start practicing removing our feelings from it, and we look at what's happening, we can find a more peaceful place to live. But again, our emotions and our feelings are so strong, our beliefs are so strong, that we don't care about the truth. The truth supposedly will set you free. I just so happen to believe that because it's been proven to me. And I guess moving forward in my life, I am practicing removing my thoughts, feelings, my beliefs, and my emotions from equations to the best of my ability. You can't always do it, because if somebody comes around messing with your family, that's a different story. You are emotionally attached and your emotions do take over. But when we can examine what is actually being said, presented, or what we're dealing with in terms of a problem or chaos, and we can address it minus how we feel personally, I think we'll save ourselves from a lot of chaos and a lot of disagreement and a whole lot of fighting. I really wish you would continue with the exercise with me, which you are clearly not willing to do. Why? I don't know. I'll just now have to make my own conclusion, is that you don't want to deal with what's in front of you, where you want to deal with your emotions. And that's why I'm doing these exercises. I'm having conversations with people, some recorded, some not, and I'm trying to bring awareness to how we process information, because people hear things and they understand something different. People say things and they even mean something different. I can say something and you can think I said something else, but these kinds of hard conversations is how we get to the bottom of why we are, you know, so we don't have to fight. I believe misunderstanding is the biggest problem we have in society today. And it's a part of why people are out there rioting right now, is because we don't do what I'm trying to do right now. And that's have a conversation with you with reason.
Come here. Look at me, boy. Don't you lose your temper with that man. This is world. We just living in it. You hear me? Now get on back to work.
The Bible says, brother, let's reason together. And we don't have to like you know, something in order to understand it or to be okay with it or to go along with it. And the fact that we don't like it is why we throw such a hard fit. Universal principles and points of reference are all we have to go on. If something has been established as a norm for society, we have to give that some kind of credibility when we are hashing out issues. If the Constitution says all men are created equal, then we don't have an argument as to why some people are treated differently. We just need to get to the bottom of why. And that conversation is hard to have. And I won't be on this subject long. There's a billion things that I'm going to do. I found a whole new calling, and it's not going to be easy. As a matter of fact, I've got to figure out how to get my mind back after these types of conversations, because they do,
right.
You know, they do get intense.